Welcome back to War Room for Courageous Wives, and of course, I'm here giving you your daily marriage affirmation and confession. I want to encourage you, though, that on days that I do not post, I'm still doing the affirmations, and you should still do them too. There's a really cool app called I Am, I believe. Just search for it on the App Store or Google Play Store. It's called I Am, and it's an app where it gives you affirmations throughout the day, just kind of like the prayer reminder app. This one reminds you to speak life throughout the day. There are some already in there for different categories. Let me pull it up so I can see. So there's different categories. There is self-care, personal growth, stress and anxiety, health and well-being, love and relationships, work and career, happiness and life, and then nighttime. I guess that's one where you kind of like you end your day, you end your day on like positive words, that sort of thing. And then there's gratitude, and then there's a section for you to make your own affirmations. I made a section called marriage, of course. And in there, I have affirmations, some that I've already said on this podcast and some that I will say today and future. And so I have mine, so you can set your reminders for every day or whatever, you know, how often you want them to remind you and how many times throughout the day. And so I have from 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. every single day, 7 times a day, marriage affirmations. Also, I put a reminder for stress and anxiety because I'm always anxious. And then I have one for nighttime so that I can end my day with a positive like reminder and positive words. So I encourage you to download that app. It's free. There's a free trial. I'm sorry, it's not free. There's a free trial, and then it's $20 for the year, which is really, really affordable, and it's just useful. I like stuff because, like I said, we have to be accountable. I mean, not accountable. We have to be intentional about what we're doing as far as like speaking life and praying. Like, I am making like an intentional effort to make sure that I'm doing this. Because, you know, we're in a spiritual battle, and we will talk about that a little later. But before we get into the affirmation or confession today, I, of course, want to share something with you. So a lot of, since, you know, we started this podcast, a lot of people have been hitting me up, sending me messages and asking questions and stuff like that, and which is good. And I'm always down to, you know, help any way I can. And that's why we have this podcast, because me and my sister were walking through this wifehood journey together, and we, you know, we call on each other a lot of times for stuff. I also have wise counsel that I call on to. And so, like I said, this podcast is about us sharing information, sharing this experience, sharing this journey, and holding each other accountable and just kind of walking through it together. So, however, I just want to, I want everyone to be mindful that, you know, we can only be led by the Holy Spirit. You know, Jesus is the ultimate guide in our life. No other person will do. You know, this is why it makes like those step-by-step programs so dangerous. I don't know if you guys have ever seen like those programs where it's like, oh, you know, if you want to improve your marriage, do this. If you want to improve your life in this way, do this. You know, it makes those programs very dangerous, because the Holy Spirit is the only guide that we need. No other person will do. You know, being led, if you create rules to follow instead of being led by our ultimate guide, we can easily be misled. John 16:13 says, however, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. You know, the enemy will use articles, advice from friends, even sermons to create a dependency on anything but the Holy Spirit. He doesn't want us to depend on the Holy Spirit. He doesn't want us to be led by God. You know, God is everywhere at all times and knows all things. You know, because men and women are in the flesh, we can't ever treat them like gurus. You know what I mean? Like, only the Holy Spirit can guide us. The Bible makes it clear that God is everywhere at all times, and we can trust his instructions. Psalms 139 7 through 10 says, "Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend into heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me." You know, if God wants to speak to you, he'll make it known. He will make it clear. You know, running to pastors who claim to be prophets, searching online and asking everyone around you for advice is great. But it's a way that if you become dependent on it, you will replace the Holy Spirit and become dependent on men, which is very, very dangerous. And you don't want to mess around with that. You know, sometimes we want answers now. We're so desperate for answers now. And I believe that when we will pray, we will pay the price for demanding God's voice to come out of season. You know, God's timing is perfect. We have to trust his timing. You know, I just urge you guys to, you know, stop seeking answers and start following and the one who has them all, the Holy Spirit. You know, when it's time for you to hear from God, he'll make it known. If there's something that he needs to reveal to you, he'll reveal it. You know, you don't have to go searching for it. You know, we must leave room for our faith and trust God's timing. I can't stress that enough. When you go to people for help, you are putting more trust in the creation than the creator. When you try to do things in your own power, you know, God will keep you in those fires. You know, the point of the fire is to purify us, you know, from those exact problems, dependency, pride, placing faith in men over God, and so on. It's so many things, you know. God will delay the breakthrough that you're looking for until you stop doing that, until you're ready. You know, any sin in our lives needs to be removed. Any imperfections have to go. You know, ask God what is standing in the way of your victory. And when he shows you, ask him for the strength to overcome it. And when I say your, you know, what's standing in the way, like any imperfections, I'm talking about what I just said, your dependency, you know, not waiting on God, pride, you know, the spirit of like urgency, needing it right now, not having patience, that sort of thing. Putting faith in men over God, over God, things like that. You know, when you're in the valley, we are set aside to draw closer to our Father while in the valley. You know, he wants us to himself. Get out of his way and watch him do a miracle, because he will. He wants to. You can do this. Let go and let God. Honestly, I can't stress that enough. God will share his glory with no one. So the word in Isaiah says, Isaiah 42 and 8 says, you know, "I am the Lord. That is my name, and my glory I will give to no other, nor my praise." He's saying he wants us to come to him. That's the only way. He's the only way that we're going to get to our victory, no matter what it is, whether it's in your marriage, whether it's in your career, whatever you're going through, whatever you're seeking answers for, whatever you're needing direction on. Ask the Holy Spirit. Pray. Build a relationship with him. That this is what this challenge is about. It's about, you know, making sure that our mind and our actions and our words are in line with God and the Holy Spirit. And that's how he's going to lead us. That's how he's going to speak to you. That's how you're going to build that connection with him, so that you won't, you know, have questions about what you need to do, because you're trusting God. You're praying consistently. You're speaking words of life consistency. You know, you're getting out of God's way and you're allowing him to work. That's what we need to focus on, not depending on, you know, the next pastor, the next guru, the next coach to tell you something. You can go to the Father yourself. He wants to hear from you. He wants to build that connection and that relationship with you. Don't be deceived. You know, not saying that there, you know, people are out to deceive you on purpose or mislead you on purpose, but we're all human. We're all flesh. You know, and also you should be mindful of the people you're going to. Do your due diligence, you know, make sure, you know, you understand what their beliefs are, because you don't want to, you know, be agreeing to something that is going to be detrimental to your marriage or to your life. So I'm sorry to say, but the Christian life is not a playground. It's a battleground. God wants us to be victorious and not defeated in the spiritual war zone that we find ourselves in daily, almost daily. God has provided an armor for the spiritual war zone that we're in because it has to be appropriate for the fight. If we use fleshly armor in a spiritual battle, then you're going to lose because it won't be appropriate for the enemy that you're fighting, Satan. Satan, the demonic world and the realm of evil are sources of attack. Everything physical and visible is preceded by something invisible and spiritual. So if you want to be victorious over your struggles in this physical world, you're going to have to learn to fight against the spiritual invisible forces that are coming against you. And that is why it's absolutely critical that you know and understand and utilize the armor of God that He's provided for us. So you do not fight in defeat, but in expectation of a victory. Speaking your words to affirmation, allowing the Holy Spirit to lead you, not being misled by, you know, a guru or, you know, a so-called prophet. Praying, constantly being in prayer about everything, every single thing. Pray, ask God about it. Do not move unless the Holy Spirit gives you total and complete peace to do so. Hello, Courageous Wives. Before we get to our confession for today, I do have to interrupt. I'm so sorry, but you will thank me later because I'm here to tell you about this amazing platform, Anchor. If you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. So if you're like me and you have a lot to say or you have a lot in your mind and you just want to get it off your chest, maybe starting a podcast is something that you can do too. It's free. There's creation tools that allows you to record, distribute, and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. And Anchor will also help you distribute your podcast so that you can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and so many more. You can make money from your podcast with minimum listenership. I mean, that's super cool, right? Especially if you're just starting out like me. It's everything you need to make a podcast all in one place. So download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started. Okay, back to it. Today's affirmation. My husband and I are spirit-led and we walk God's plan out every single day. Our home is a haven of love, peace, and harmony, and God's blessings are overtaking us.